You're watching Around Town with Henry Dorman.
Around Town is sponsored by Chemung Canal Trust Company. They're really nice people. Trust is their middle name. Service is their motto. And I like them a lot, and that's why I bank there. If you ever come by to look me up, I'll be in the vault. Safe place.
Wouldn't you like to go inside the publishing business and find out how do you put a magazine together? And why do you go and get one magazine as opposed to another? But there's one here, Mountain Home Magazine, and these are the Capuzzo, right?
Right, Capuzzo.
Right. You gotta have the hand with
this. Right.
Who are the owners and publishers of this, and it's published in Wellsboro. And it goes here to Corning, it goes to Elmira, it goes to all over the area of the Finger Lakes. Mm-hmm. And they are really nice people. And we just thought we'd chat with them to find out how you did this. Did you create it?
Yes, we did.
You really started from the bottom.
From scratch, 10 years ago.
10 years ago.
10 years ago, December was our first issue.
And now you're wealthy publishing moguls.
Oh, exactly.
He even wore a suit.
Yeah, I thought we were going to talk about buying Leadership Magazine, but that's not this meeting, I guess. Oh, I almost had the wrong meeting. No, it's a mom-and-pop operation, and it's been a joy of discovery, really, to connect with the local community, with the Twin Tiers, with a regional magazine for the Twin Tiers.
But you have, I understood that you have some exclusive things on real estate, cabins to rent, things to buy, all kinds of wonderful bargains. I see I open up the garlic.
Yeah.
So we got food too.
Yes.
Food. It's a regional magazine for the Twin Tiers, the Finger Lakes, down to central, north central Pennsylvania. And we have a lot of prize winning stories, feature stories, like on the McKenzie brothers, we call them, at Finger Lakes Distillery. And one of the early stories on their success there we did. And on a story motivated by the street right outside the window here in Corning on the new plates designed by the Corning designers.
Isn't that funny? We did stories on the show here with both.
Did you?
Yes, we did, including one with her.
Yes.
See, great minds think alike.
That's right.
Now, who really runs the magazine, both of you?
Well, Mike does more work.
Look at both of you. Don't they make a beautiful couple? I mean, he's dressed up and she's dressed up. And they really did a nice thing for the interview. I had to put a little editorial in there.
Thank you. Yeah,
well,
sorry I interrupted you.
Now, I sort of run the day-to-day, and Mike consults on, we're co-publishers, co-founders. I was looking for a day job when we moved back to my hometown of Wellsboro from Philadelphia, where we had met at the Philadelphia Inquirer. Oh. And I was a restaurant critic for Philadelphia Magazine.
No, that was Annenberg, wasn't it?
It was Annenberg
way back. Yeah.
But it was Knight Ridder when we were there.
Yeah.
And so I had just finished a degree in architecture and landscape architecture. And I thought, I want to write about land and, as you said, cabins and camps and all of that wonderful stuff.
And bargains.
Yeah, and bargains, right? So we started, it was originally on newsprint, and it quickly evolved to, our advertisers wanted sort of a higher end product to advertise mm-hmm. their goods, because we have a lot of wonderful arts and culture. And so we eventually evolved into a glossy publication printed in Ithaca. And it's become...
Is there a printer in Wellsboro?
No.
No?
No. Not for this kind. Yeah.
They have good printers in Ithaca.
Yes, they do have good printers. We have a very good printer.
Oh, I need to know this for the station. It's very important. Everybody at the station make a note. Who sells the advertising?
Well...
We have a great ad team, and I would be the champion for that.
The station is looking for new people to sell advertising.
Okay, I'm not giving out any names.
I had to ask.
I'm very happy with our team. So, and I might have to take their names out of the masthead now. But
some of the stories, we're basically a story-driven publication. Both of our backgrounds are storytellers, journalists, writers, authors, and. So
we're accidental publishers.
I have a couple of New York Times bestselling books, one on the first shark attack in American history close to shore, and the other one called The Murder Room, but that's a different story. But the point of it is that we came here thinking maybe we knew something about storytelling. We both worked for the Philadelphia Inquirer, and we learned from the community. The community has done this publication because writers from the Finger Lakes, Wellsboro, Williamsport, a lot in New York, Corning, writers and photographers, artists have contributed their talents to this mom-and-pop operation, and it's won, I think we've won probably more, those people have won more editorial awards than probably any magazine of a similar size in the country because of their talents. And it's been amazing to watch. It's been a real sort of community front porch, I guess you'd call it.
You come out once a month.
Yes.
Once a month, and we've won...
Year-round.
Year-round. Mm-hmm. January, you know, every month, and now we have some more localized publications. We're doing a magazine for Julie Van Ness at the Wellsboro Chamber of Commerce. Mm-hmm. We do their Explore Wellsboro. It's a travel book, but it's story driven. Mm-hmm. So it's stories about the people and the places and the boutiques and restaurants in Wellsboro. And we recently did one for the Corning Gaffer District. Mm-hmm. The Gaffer District Guide, we did one at the Holiday, and we just did one that came out a few weeks ago. So those are special publications for special markets.
Yeah, so you do special things.
Right.
But after all of this, which and the special things are an extent of this,
yes.
What do you do next? You're so successful, you have a lot of class in your operation. What are you going to do next?
Well, let me see. One of the things
you're not going into television.
We get excited. No, only when the next book comes out, you know.
Yeah.
We get excited about just telling stories. I mean, we have an incredible story coming up. I think we'll have a national scoop. We're covering the presidential election in November like no one else. We're having a woman who is a historian of the Civil War is going to do. We're covering the election of 1860. Mm-hmm. And the headline I'm going to give away right now is Lincoln Wins. We're going to look back at what it was like when 70-80% of northern Pennsylvania and southern New York was voting for Lincoln and what the life was like on the ground that day. November 7th or so, whatever it was, 1860.
Well, in those days, if you look at the history books, I keep watching television now and I see Donald Trump and I see Hillary Clinton and I hear these terrible, terrible things being talked by everybody. But when you look back in history during Lincoln's day, it was worse.
Oh, yeah, Adams and Jefferson, two of the sort of noblest, literary, gentlemanly types in our mind. I think one of them called the other the daughter of a whore's something, you know, that was the nicest word.
Yeah.
Something, you know, so yeah, they were, it was
it's
rough
amazing.
And tumble.
They didn't have libel laws in those days.
Oh, they didn't? I didn't know that.
No, they had laws, but not the way we have them today. Even today it's hard because you have to give proof of loss.
Right.
And in those days, they just knocked everything.
So you're saying that politics has cleaned up its act. That's kind of shocking. That's breaking news right there.
It's a surprise. Who's going to win, do you know?
Well, I think Lincoln has a clear edge over Douglas.
I think you are both wonderful.
Thank you so much.
You run a grand operation, and if people want to receive copies, can they call you?
Yes, sure. And we do have subscribers. It's a free magazine. We print 20,000 a month. But if you want to subscribe, if you're outside of our distribution area, which is pretty big, from Geneva to Montoursville and, you know, west from Countersport to Wysox in Pennsylvania. But if you want it home delivered, we do have a subscription list.
And how do they contact you?
Just call the office.
What's the number?
570-724-3838.
And website?
Mountainhomemag.com.
You're going to be flooded with requests.
I know. I'm excited about that. Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Don't forget, give them a call. It's worth reading. They have everything. Bargains.
Around Town with Henry Dorman will return in a moment.
Truly, this is home. I know that's our slogan here, but this is my home. So, I mean, I do care about it. My family's here. My friends are here. I went to school here. I think I take a lot of pride in covering stories. When I go out and talk, whether it's about, you know, budget cuts or, you know, a new store opening that's directly impacting taxes my family pays or, you know, the quality of life that my family and friends have here. This is home.
Life, it never stops moving, getting from here to there. Managing long hours at work, juggling a busy home. You need a bank that keeps up. That's Chemung Canal Trust Company. Bank online. Bank with our mobile app. deposit a check with your smartphone, open an account at Chemung Canal, and bank with us anywhere, anytime. Chemung Canal Trust Company, member FDIC, equal housing lender.
Don't wait. Communicate. Make your emergency plan today.
We now return to Around Town with Henry Dorman.
Are you looking for an interesting, fascinating restaurant to go to? There are many, too many, but in Corning there's one that's really super, and it's called the Three Birds. And the Leonards are the owners. And I have known them for over 10 years when I was a child, and they first started the restaurant. And it's been successful, extremely successful ever since. In Corning, street address?
73 East Market.
East Market. A hop, skip, and a jump from any place, including Elmira. And the phone number?
607-936-8862.
And they look exactly the same as they did when I interviewed them the first time 10 years ago. I don't know how they do it. Must be the food.
The wine.
And the wine. Is he sharp? Now you're open every day for lunch and dinner, only dinner?
Just dinner. Six days a week.
And 6 days a week, closed Sunday?
Correct.
And so open at what time?
4 o'clock.
4 o'clock to closing time?
Correct.
What have you done that's different in the last 10 years? Or what have you done that's newsworthy? Or what have you done that you want to talk about to have people mob you with reservations?
Wow. Food's been a big one.
I told him before, I said, if you look at me this way, you've got a profile of him there. If you look at him profile, he looks just like a Shakespearean actor, doesn't he? He's got that John Barrymore nose. You don't mind my
kibitzing
with you a little.
Absolutely not.
Good.
Complimenting.
Well, it is.
You always are complimenting.
Well, it's true. Not only that's true, but she's just as beautiful as she was 10 years, too.
Oh, thank you.
Ha ha ha. Now, what are you going to say about the restaurant that's going to make people come in? Have you got new specials? Do you have new things happening? The bar is mobbed on weekends and during the week, too.
Well, we're very fortunate. Starting at about 4 o'clock, we tend to get the folks that come out of, want the early cocktail, if you will, at 4, and then usually go home by then, 5 o'clock, dinner reservations start. In terms of change, I think we've been fortunate to have not changed, to be honest with you.
Well, I remember them before they had their first child, and now your children are coming in as customers.
Well, yes, they do. We're
and
fortunate.
And they get free meals.
Ha ha. Well, what's that, about 2 times a year, maybe?
Right. They wish it was more.
Sure.
How old are they now?
10 and 7.
10 and 7.
And we
keep
saying, as soon as they can reach the button on the dish machine, they're coming to work.
Uh-huh. Mm-hmm. Well, you were always wonderful parents. I remember when you first had the first and the second, and we did interviews then, too.
Yes, we did.
And it's so wonderful that you had such a great success.
Fortunate. We just really try to do what we do best, and that is our dinners. And, of course, we do banquets upstairs.
You're not catering, though.
We'll do off-site catering, sure. Mm-hmm. It usually tends to be around the holiday season, November, December being our prime time, if you will.
Now, we're here in the restaurant. What are we going to have to eat?
Today we would have... We have maple leaf duck breast with a Bing cherry port demi. Uh-huh. That will be with parsnips. We have fresh halibut that came in today. We have wonderful tuna. Tonight, and only on Wednesday, we do a sushi bar. Mm-hmm. That is, we bring in a special chef from outside the area on Wednesday. His name is Dan, and we put up a sushi bar right in the restaurant.
But this is one of the very, very few, if any, sushi bars in the whole area. I don't think there's one outside of Elmira.
No, there's not, and that's why we just chose to do it one day. It's just, for us, it's the showcase of just fresh ingredients. There's nothing better than coming in and seeing, wonderful jailhouse salmon or tuna cut up and sliced up and rolled right in front of you, custom ordered. One day a week, though.
I could make it.
And, of course, you get that Pacific Rim marriages real well with the classical French approach that we traditionally have and have always been known to have at Three Birds?
Now, he has the gift of gab.
He does.
What are you going to do to compete?
So he's the chef. He's constantly talking about the food, the wonderful food. We're fortunate to have two sous chefs, one of which has been with us for 10-plus years. So
she's good, too.
Fortunate. Mm-hmm. But our banquet facility, I feel really lucky that some of the front of the house people that have been working with me on our banquets upstairs have been with us for 7-plus years. Mm. Our banquet room accommodates up to 85 people. We do dinners, we'll do lunches, corporate events, a lot of holiday gatherings. It's a large space with great windows overlooking Market Street. Proud to have that as well.
How, after two children, do you stay so skinny? And how does he stay so skinny, being a chef and knowing food?
It's having two children that keeps you
we
running around.
We move just as much as we eat.
And you live nearby?
We do. We live in Painted Post, which is very nice.
Sure.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. That's an easy commute.
Mm-hmm.
Now, what other events are going to take place that people should know about and come and visit you for dinner? Are there events in Corning itself that will bring people so that they can come here for dinner after the event?
Well, we just wrapped up a great weekend with Corning's Glass Fest. That's a great weekend with vendors and live music on the street. There's a couple of events throughout the summer that'll showcase not only Market Street, but Bridge Street. And we always have a presence on those, and guests usually come afterwards after they enjoy the live music and tents.
Wine Glass Marathon?
Mm-hmm, that'll be in October.
You always had a lot of fun in what you did. And I find in interviews that's something that repeats itself with successful people. They really enjoy what they do, and they have such a fun, good time doing it. And you have a double fun good time because your wife is here too.
Well, and truthfully, it makes it easier. She runs the front of the house, if you will, in a maitre d' capacity, and I simply oversee the kitchen as a chef de cuisine, chef of the food, along with my two sous chefs, and of course I have a garde manger chef, two of them.
You speak good French.
Un petit peu. A vous?
Un petit peu.
Trivial.
Voila, what are we going to do now? We're getting spoiled. I listened to him talking about the food, and the menu itself is something. Anybody can come and look at the menu.
Absolutely.
The menu is a work of art.
Well, and you can also pick that up on social media in terms of TripAdvisor, Yelp, Facebook. So, I mean, you type in Three Birds Restaurant, and you'll get all the wonderful things about us. We do try to work with that part of social media a lot in terms of getting our name out. It's about the only form of advertising we do, because we do change the menu over seasonally 4 times a year.
How did you come up with the name Three Birds?
Three Birds. If I had a dime for every time I told the story.
I know. You've told it to me many times.
It's a simple one. I just, many years ago, while in Rochester, after getting done with my studies and having good fortune at a restaurant called Park Avenue Pub, we had cabaret tables sitting on the dining patio, and there was two birds fighting over a piece of bread. A third one came down and ripped it apart and essentially shared the bread. And I said, I was looking outside of the window, and I said, wow, look at those three birds. And if I ever opened up a restaurant, I would call it the Three Birds.
This is a wedding made in heaven. You've got to come here. There's such nice people, and such great food, and really lovely combination. So thank you, and thank you. It's nice to be back here for an anniversary.
It's a pleasure.
Thank you.
Thank you.
If you come by soon, I'll be here, sitting at the nicest table, eating like there's no tomorrow.
Around Town with Henry Dorman will return in a moment.
Life, it never stops moving. Getting from here to there. Managing long hours at work. Juggling a busy home. You need a bank that keeps up. That's Chemung Canal Trust Company. Bank online. Bank with our mobile app. Deposit a check with your smartphone. Open an account at Chemung Canal and bank with us anywhere, anytime. Chemung Canal Trust Company. Member FDIC. Equal housing lender.
WENY News, the only local station with a full-time Washington, D.C. bureau watching out for you.
Your Marine Corps' way of life is to defend the American way of life. every day. No matter where we serve, we take a stand for our nation, for each other, for us all. The few, the proud, the Marines.
We now return to Around Town with Henry Dorman.
Are you aging? Because if you are, you're going to qualify for a plan that is terrific, and we're just going to tell you about it. But first, I want to introduce my girlfriend. This is my new girlfriend. Her name is Ann Darling, and with a name like Ann Darling, you can't go wrong. And she's the founding leader. Are you the founding lady?
I guess so, yes.
The founding lady of this organization, which will be doing things for you. So listen in, and I'm going to leave it to you to introduce everyone else.
Thank you.
You've got an easy name to remember.
This is Judy Garrett, our president, and Tom Hart, our second vice president.
And what's the name of the group?
Corning Area Aging in Place. And our mission is to assist seniors in the Corning area to remain in their homes safely as they age instead of moving to a retirement community or assisted living as long as they wish to do so. It all began 10 years with an article in the New York Times about a group in Boston that was doing exactly that. They called themselves Beacon Hill Village, and since then there are hundreds of organizations all over the country that are attempting to do what they
What do you
are
do,
doing.
Really?
What do, you what really do we do?
You have people come in every week, and you...
No.
No?
Well, what we do are to have informational programs every week, every month, rather, during spring and fall. We advocate for aging in place, and we also are a work in progress. We're interested in everything new that can help seniors to stay in their homes. Our programs are very interesting, and Tom can tell you more about that.
I can. Good time to do that?
I think so.
Well, typically the third Thursday of the month through the winter months into June, and then in the fall, we meet right here in the location where we are.
Which is where?
Which is the First Congregational Church on Pulteney at Pritchard in downtown Corning. I think I like to start with what's about to happen as opposed to what has happened. And this month our speaker is one of our more recent board members, Sue Gruber, who is been certified as a what we call a certified aging in place specialist.
But what do you do for the aging? What exactly is this all about?
The people come. We have a list of well over 300 people that are familiar with what we do. We come to know them. They are our friends, if you will. And we publish in the newspaper, also send out postcards for upcoming meetings. And
but what do you do besides having meetings? You have a lot of services.
Well, let me jump in here.
Sure.
Yeah. Because, as Ann said, when Beacon Hill Village, that program has just a fantastic array of, they have a coordinator and they help bring services to individuals to keep them in their home. We tried that, but we could not afford a coordinator. So what we've done is have monthly meetings of topics that will help people as they age in place.
Like?
Well, this upcoming one about Sue Gruber talking about how you modify your home so that you can remain in it. The past month, Nancy Williamson from the credit union, Serbia Credit Union, talked about how we, things we need to know to guard our finances.
Mm-hmm.
For instance, the chip versus the stripe on your credit card. Mm-hmm. So there was a lot of information she had about that. Some of the actual things we've done is, the first thing is a solutions directory. It looks like this.
This is to help you to age in your home rather than to go to a nursing home.
Correct.
Right.
As long as it's safe to do so.
Yeah.
That's really our mission. And the solutions directory, you know, most of us are used to doing things on our own.
Mm-hmm.
But there comes a time when you really ought not be going up the ladder, cleaning your gutter and whatnot. So members gave us the names of their service providers, Carol Iberson at Graphic Solutions helped us design this really handy brochure, and this is something we give out at our meetings. We like donations for it, but we don't sell it. It's just, if you come to our meeting, you're welcome to have one of
these. And if people want to come to the meeting or want more information, do they telephone you or look at the computer?
Good that you mentioned that, because we've just got a website, and the information will be here on our board for later on. Roger Bartholomew and his daughter Leslie, who is a designer in Rhode Island, who also designed this banner, by the way, she's put together a website for us, and she's taught her father how to keep it up to date, so mm-hmm. people can go there, find out what programs are coming up, what time.
Roger being a board member.
Yes, Roger is a board member.
So in essence, you are helping aging people stay out of nursing homes and live in their homes as long as they can do so safely.
That's correct.
And giving them tips on how to do this, whether it be cleaning, whether it be getting help to clean, whether it be cooking, getting meals in,
absolutely.
All the places that would supply these things to you.
Now, that is all true, but there probably will come a time in our lives where we might not even be able to figure out who to call in mm-hmm. this book. And so we're working closely with the Steuben County Office for Aging, as well as Linda Teeter at the Steuben Senior Services Fund, to bring Full Circle America to our area. This is a program, it's a brainchild of a Dr. Alan Teal out of Maine. And it's kind of an integrated program that would involve the person, such as myself, with volunteers, as well as their medical, their own physician, and technology. And you know, we're finding technology can be used in all kinds of ways. Mm-hmm. And Dr. Teal, who will actually be here in another week, is helping us develop this program.
What will that program do?
Well, for instance, right now we have, I don't know if we have that paper here, but Linda Teeter's mother is actually a client right now who is using this. And one of the basic things, it'll hook up your television so that you can communicate with your doctor, you can communicate with your family who might be out of the area through Skype. And that's how Linda's is working right now with her mother. There's a lot about the technology that we were just talking about recently. It's designed to be very simple, so maybe the individual person might be able to figure it out. But
is there a charge for this?
There will be a monthly charge, mm-hmm. but it'll be so much less than going in assisted living or a nursing home.
Does the government pay for any of it?
No. This is privately done. Mm-hmm. But Dr. Teal is very much aware of people's limited resources as they get older, and is trying ever so well to make this an affordable program.
You're very sharp.
Bless your heart.
You're all very sharp. And
you're
really organizing things so well, and what a great help.
I should say that Full Service America has just hired a coordinator, a local gal named Kate Patterson. I think by the time this airs, maybe it's all right to announce her name. It's being funded by a couple of local people are helping with this cost. I probably shouldn't say who that is, should I?
I don't think so. No. And also the State Office for the Aging.
The State Office, mm-hmm. they've been great about a grant. But it is going to happen. Yeah. We're very positive.
And you're in the forefront, and we thank you
yes.
very, very much. Ann Darling.
You're very welcome.
I love this, Ann. I love this name. Thank
Judy
you so much.
Thank you.
My pleasure.
Now they can call the number.
Yes, on our website there is a number to call to find out specific information, but the website's pretty complete.
I can't wait to get older. Boy, oh boy, this this place has everything. Give them a call. I will be here chatting with them. I want to know about this television that connects with everybody.
Yeah, it's pretty cool.
We can connect together. I found a whole new batch of friends. We'll see you here.
You're watching WENY HD.